13 kids came to a genetics and genealogy summer camp to research themselves, right down to their DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, the blueprint of life. But where do you find DNA? How do you get it? Turns out, it's in nearly every cell in your body.
My goal is only to light the fire, and that's the fire of the pursuit of learning.
We really wanted to target middle school kids because they are the most impressionable. They're the ones that are trying to make sense of the world.
If you give kids space and resources and time to dig into the things that captivate them most, then they'll soar.
It's exciting to learn how to find your ancestry. And if you master those skills, you can use those skills to study just about anything.
We have to be very, very careful. What we're gonna do now is going to be fascinating. We're going to extract actual DNA. Yes, I got a bunch of just now, right? Now, why did you make that face?
Because normally when you extract DNA, you extract it from people or animals. And DNA is in your blood, so you have to get through the skin and into a vein to extract the blood.
Beautiful. But it turns out you don't really need that. With some basic chemistry, right, we can actually extract DNA from cells, from our cells. It's actually not that hard. Yeah, we're going to actually see it. We are going to see DNA, and not only are we going to see DNA, we're going to see yours.
First, we had this little cup filled with salt water.
Dude, you can sit.
All right, let's get this one here.
And we had to put it all in our mouth and swish really vigorously to get cheek cells.
All right, everybody take their cup. And then we're gonna go for 60 seconds. All right, count of three. One, two, three. Vigorously swish. Vigorously.
It was really hard because we were all laughing like a lot.
Don't look at me, I'll make you guys laugh. Really, the better you do it, the more cheek cells you get.
Yeah, this is disgusting.
All right, number four.
You got one here. Write that number down. Carefully pour it in the tube and hold it. Just hold it.
It's easier if you pinch it.
There you go. Sharing.
It smells really bad.
When you have something negative, what do you need to kind of be able to really kind of make this stuff visible? It's the bond to something positive, okay? Positive. So basically the salt, right? A salt kind of is going to be able to really, really bind to the DNA so that we can see it. So this kind of is going to allow us to visualize it a little bit later, okay?
We had to pour some soap in the test tubes.
The soap makes it so the cheek cells come apart.
And make sure you don't
stay.
Is that
you
it?
Yeah.
5 milliliters.
So
about here.
Yeah. Can you do mine?
One, two, three. Two, three. How'd you guys go on your own?
The soap breaks open the cells and the cell nuclei by destroying its membranes, releasing the DNA into solution.
And once we shook it, mentors went around and poured rubbing alcohol around the rim.
Human DNA is hard to see. A million strands can fit into the period on the end of a sentence. But in this experiment, because there are so many strands clumped together, they suddenly become visible.
It was like a separate layer that your DNA strands were in, and you could see the DNA strands, and it was really cool because you could see them like twirling around.
I want them to see that there is a physical, tangible nature to this very ethereal DNA idea. I want kids to look at it and be like, this is part of who I am.
Get cloudy, that's the DNA condensing.
Oh, that's so cool.
You're good to go. You have a string float. Look at that string floating around. You see that white, cloudy substance? Guess what that is?
DNA.
Yeah.
Okay.
And not just any DNA, yours.
Cool.
That's cool.
All right.
The way that we set up this DNA extraction is, for the first round, everybody does it step by step together, pausing to make sense of, why are we rinsing in saline and not water? Why are we using soap? What's the point of that? Why ethanol? To get kids thinking about, these decisions that we make aren't accidental, but they're not absolute. Like, perhaps they could be modified. Challenge it. Do something different.
Wait, a question.
Would it differ if you use it in, like, would it differ if you use a different alcohol?
That's a good question. Maybe we can investigate that. Maybe you can try that, right? This extraction with a bunch of different types of alcohol. There's the alcohol we have called isopropyl alcohol. Maybe that's an experiment to do. So keep that in mind when it comes to your projects. Any other questions?
I want kids to, on the first day, realize that this is more about them and their discovery and their curiosity than it is about being right.
Every living thing on Earth has DNA. So to prove it, the campers would use the same procedure to extract DNA from strawberries.
You guys are so smart. I trust you now. Now we can just kind of follow the instructions on our own, right?
Strawberries have more copies of the chromosomes than humans do. Humans only have 2 copies, and strawberries have 8.
So get the air out of the bag. Now we're gonna mash it. We're gonna mash it, okay? There you go. Oh, perfect. Oh, yeah, that's better.
Oh, yeah. Whoopsie, you didn't do that carefully.
I'm gonna add right to yours, okay?
Close up the bag and mix it up.
Be very careful when you're doing this. There you go. Beautiful. Beautiful.
Oh, no.
There you go. It's like a cake, like cake icing.
How much do we have? How's it looking?
Like nothing.
Just starting. Well, yours is condensing quickly. Do you see that?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's all DNA.
One of the advantages is showing them that living organisms have DNA. We share this in common. And in fact, something like 70% of strawberry DNA is represented in human DNA.
Go show Professor O that.
Professor O! I have so much DNA.
Oh, gosh!
I match mine a lot.
Wow!
That was pretty amazing. I had like the first and second most DNA.
I want kids doing science in community because I want to develop a sense of a community of scientists. It's all about collaboration and communication and co-discussion and co-sense making.
What did you do to those poor strawberries?
I mashed them up.
Some people had very particular methods for mashing them up. If you mashed them up less, do you think you'd see less DNA?
Yeah.
If you use a larger or smaller strawberry, do you think you see more or less DNA?
More.
Right. That's a hypothesis.
I squeeze.
We can test that using the same method. We can begin to think about these things.
We should do 1, 2, 3, 4. So 23.
I like bananas, but that banana is bad.
You dropped it.
I think that's enough kiwi.
The campers have witnessed their own DNA.
This is cool.
But what does their DNA say about them? What does it say about their ancestors? Next time on Finding Your Roots, the Seedlings.
Kids love to study themselves. We can show you how you can bring the tools of finding your roots into your after-school program, summer camp, or classroom. Check out what happens when kids study their own DNA and family history by viewing our education programs and trying our research-based curriculum materials. For more information, visit us online.
Major support for Finding Your Roots, the Seedlings, has been provided by the Benkovic Family Foundation, with additional support from WETA, Public Television for Greater Washington, the Hutchins Center for African and African American Research at Harvard, and the following.